unfazed by what happened in Cincinnati. And West Virginia controls the tap. What kind of tempo will we have in this ball game?
Well, a trip to Tampa in March always unfazed you and can relax you. But I think an up-tempo type game for West Virginia as far as getting in your face on the defensive part of the floor.
This is Butler out high. Devin Ebanks had a tremendous freshman year. Butler out to get the ball. Swings it over. Ruoff. Butler driving. Shot clock running down. Good sequence defensively for South Florida. And the fall away is short. Jones lost it off his fingertips, and Wellington Smith runs it down.
Well, South Florida struggled to score all season long, but one thing they do well is they'll get up and defend. Stan Heath has always been a very good defensive coach going back to his Arkansas days.
West Virginia starting lineup, the Mountaineers at 8-7 in the Big East. Howard, or rather, there you go, Ruoff, Bryant, Butler, Ebanks, and Smith. West Virginia at 19-9.
Devin Ebanks, an outstanding game at Cincinnati earlier this week, 14 rebounds for the freshman.
All right, now we go with the University of South Florida. Chris Howard, Justin Limau is in the lineup. You heard Coach tell you that Jesus Verdejo is not playing. Verdejo is out. Dominique Jones, Rivas. Augustus Gilchrist is a freshman to watch. And a whistle inside, a moving screen, and that's going to be a turnover. The University of South Florida gets their first possession.
Well, Verdejo being out, you see him on the bench with crutches, and you know that is a major problem for Stan Heath, because one of their problems all year has been scoring. They average only about 60 points a game, and you take away their second score at 13 a game, they're going to have to find other ways to put the ball in the hole. Gilchrist, I look for him to be very aggressive on the interior.
It's Ruoff that draws the assignment first on Dominique Jones. Limau against Bryant. The other problem, the Bulls have depth. They don't have a whole lot of it. So they lose a guy like Verdejo, and they're really thin. Gilchrist misses his first shot, and West Virginia pushes tempo. Ruoff into the corner. Quickly it leaves the hands of Butler. Jones rips down the rebound.
Well, Butler continues to be a little cold. He and Ruoff 7-for-26 against Cincinnati in their loss.
Yeah, Ruoff himself was 3-of-15. That dunk doesn't go, but a follow. He can get his points in a lot of different areas.
Well, you know, one thing I really admire about Stan Heath's club, they have not quit on the season. You know, they've had struggled. They've had some injuries. They've had some stuff go on out on the basketball court, tough losses, but they continue to play hard. Tonight, they look like they're ready to go at West Virginia from the get-go.
Some close losses in Big East play. And when you're trying to rebuild a program, that can be a real heartbreaker. And you lose this guy, Verdejo, out of Puerto Rico, the transfer from Arizona. He has a bruised talus in his foot. They hope to get him back for the Big East Championship in New York.
Well, he played against Seton Hall this past week in their previous game, but you could see he was only about 25% of himself out there. And if you have a foot problem, there's no way you can go. And smart move tonight, resting him, trying to get him ready for the stretch run here in the last week of the season.
Devin Ebanks hits a free throw. Season numbers. Bob Huggins really likes this freshman.
There's not much not to like. He continues to improve. And you know, his game at Cincinnati this past week, up on the backboards, really filling a void for West Virginia when they weren't getting it done on the perimeter by controlling the backboards and the front line defensively.
What a roller coaster of emotions that was for Bob Huggins, from the opening ceremonies, a tearful tribute, to the frustrating last minute where they had opportunities to win that game. Jones, a little shake and bake, crossover, draws a crowd, lost the ball, took it back and got it to Gilchrist. Head fake, now he drives, kicks to Howard, here's the three. Oh my goodness.
Well, nice job by Jones there, identifying West Virginia, sending a lot of help at him as he puts the ball on the floor off the drive, finding the open shooter on the perimeter.
Well, he is the guy. He is a marked man. Bryant sets himself for a line drive free that goes.
Well, speaking of Bob Huggins earlier today, he said we couldn't stop Jones. So you know their defense today is going to be geared towards him. Anytime he puts the ball on the floor, goes toward the paint, they're going to send a second and third helper at the ball handler.
Nice backdoor look and a dunk. The flush coming from the freshman Gilchrist.
Well, West Virginia, you made the comment, Rich, they looked a little loose and relaxed. Well, on defense right now, they look a little loose and relaxed, and Bob Huggins is not happy so far with their performance on the defensive end.
He does not look loose and relaxed right now. Ebanks waiting for Bryant. Ruoff looking for his first clean look at a three. Good help defense and a bad pass. University of South Florida, not great in numbers, but playing hard right now.
Nice look on the back door. Nice seal off by Gilchrist there. Gilchrist has really come on as of late after sitting out the first semester. Look for him to have a fine career here at South Florida.
Transfer from Maryland. Howard and Limau. It's a three-guard look. Verdejo would be that third guard, but Limau gets the start. And Jones feeds the post. This is Rivas. Alex out of the Dominican Republic. Good spin, but he couldn't finish.
Nice move by Rivas there. You know, Rivas had a nice game against Seton Hall. He had 18 and 11 the other night for Stan Heath.
Bryant gets fortunate. Ebanks had the ball bounce right back to Bryant. Ruoff. Smith missed the fall away. Howard with the rebound. Backdoor cut, Jones. And a whistle, it'll go to West Virginia. Right now, Alex Ruoff and the Mountaineers behind on the road in Tampa in the Big East. In Tampa, and he is starting to lay the groundwork. Has some good recruits coming in next year. Has some young talent here with Jones and Gilchrist. Bryant fires up a two. His foot was on the line. Darryl Bryant's hit a couple shots for West Virginia.
Well, Darryl Bryant's done a nice job filling in for Joe Mazzulla this year. Ideally, you don't want a freshman to come in that's slated as your backup to run your team, but that's the adjustment Bob Huggins has been forced to make, and it's been a solid one.
Eladio Espinoza has checked in for the Bulls. Rivas, a drop step, the miss. And there is Espinoza. He's a freshman out of North Carolina.
Well, early it looks like West Virginia is having some problems with some of South Florida's length up on the front line, and you know, they're getting the ball into the interior and on the low box. They have got to put better pressure out on the perimeter and get around in the low post.
West Virginia has to do a better job of shooting the basketball as well. Butler frustrated. Smith picked it up. He was fouled. Espinoza on the reach picks up his first personal. It's a 9-7 ball game.
Wellington Smith at the line for West Virginia. He'll
shoot. West Virginia on a two-game road trip, so to speak. The Thursday night showdown in Cincinnati and then here in Tampa. Smith hits his first free throw. We showed you at the outset of the telecast that Providence and Rutgers were in the last minute. Providence ends up beating Rutgers. 73-66 is the final. Ebanks got bumped and scores.
Nice looking move there by Ebanks. Smooth freshman, giving Bob Huggins a lot in the last couple weeks.
West Virginia now up a point. 6 minutes in, first half. Jones. There is not a harder working player in the Big East than Dominique Jones. He has to work to get open. He has to work to get points. And he leads the conference in minutes played, close to 38 a game. He's got the ball right now in front of Bob Huggins. And Bryant, who was right up on him, gets called for the foul.
Well, I'm sure Bob Huggins is not disappointed with that foul. That's what they have to do. They have to get up in Jones and not let him create any space off the catch or even on the bounce, send the help at him when he drives the ball to the hole.
He's an interesting guy to guard because, as we talked about, he can shoot it from the outside. He can create off the dribble. He's a good rebounder, and there's Ruoff with the reach, and he holds Jones as well. Golf fans and club pros, registration for the 2009 ESPN National Golf Challenge is already underway for courses and teams in the Gross Net and New 55 and older senior division. For more information, log on to ESPNGolf.com. South Florida down a point with the possession. Dominique Jones has a little more breathing room, and he's got a third different defender on him now in Butler. Now Ruoff. There goes Jones, charging hard, couldn't finish, and it stays with the Bulls.
Well, that's basically one on five there, Rich. And, you know, West Virginia does a lot of switching. They have a lot of interchangeable parts out there on the floor. So you look for them to switch off ball screens. And when Jones comes off these doubles, they'll switch out as well.
Jones came off the double. Fresh shot clock for the University of South Florida. Gilchrist, a screen. And he'll get it on the baseline. Howard got Bryant in the air twice and hits the jumper.
Nice one-on-one move there by Howard. West Virginia's playing solid defense, but South Florida's countering with being very, very patient, trying to space the court and post up their big guards.
South Florida, 5 of 10 from the field. West Virginia, 3 of 7. Bryant has hit a couple shots, and he hits a third, his second three.
Well, that's what one thing Bob Huggins talked about. He said against Cincinnati, they played tough defense, but when we were even open, we couldn't knock down open shots. And tonight, Bryant is loosening up the defense for West Virginia.
Daryl Bryant, a prolific scorer in high school in the Bronx. Williams in the lane. Back out to Howard. Feed inside, and there's Jones again.
Well, that's why Jones is so special. He can create for himself off the bounce, but off the ball, he moves tremendously well, whether it's coming off screens there on the backdoor cut.
Ebanks. He'll drive. Lost it. Held ball. Possession goes to the University of South Florida. Bulls have a little momentum right now. They've gone toe-to-toe so far with West Virginia, thanks to that man, Dominique Jones.
Watching game tape, but I'll give you this, Rich, that it's March 1st. You can start paying attention to it. I mean, when they start with the bracketology stuff on February 1st, that's way too early, because if the players start hearing and seeing that, then they can lay down if they think they're in automatically, and there's a lot of basketball to be played. But I think right now we're at March. We've got about a week left of the regular season, and it's time to get serious about this. And yes, most coaches understand the RPI and what's going on at this point of the season.
And obviously every day that kind of fluctuates with a big win or a big loss. Howard, a late shot clock three that goes down.
Chris Howard. If South Florida does that today, they're going to be dangerous, because they need another scorer with Verdejo out. And Howard's a veteran. He's a streaky shooter. He's not a great shooter, but today he looks like he's on fire early.
Back to a three-point lead. Gilchrist with the steal. Ruoff got it back. Jones pries it away, and it stays with West Virginia. Stan Heath's club playing hard. The University of South Florida is in its fourth year in the Big East. They are 10-55 in Big East play, and they've never in their short history won back-to-back Big East games. But they're starting to make a little noise. The win over Marquette, the close losses, Ruoff's first three. And that's shy. Good follow. Kevin Jones.
Well, Kevin Jones and Ebanks really have been playing the best basketball of the season for West Virginia, with Butler and Ruoff going ice cold in the last few games. And here you see West Virginia playing a little zone. They played a lot of zone against Cincinnati on Thursday night.
Howard feeds the post. Gilchrist spinning. Williams' follow-away is good. Aris Williams. Almost halfway through this first half. Daryl Bryant has been the leading scorer for West Virginia. Chris Howard has done most of the scoring for the Bulls. Ebanks. Jones got it. Kevin Jones comes in the ball game and hits two buckets. And West Virginia back within a point.
Good-looking freshman out of Mount Vernon, New York. And Bob Huggins is leaning on freshmen this year with Jones, Ebanks, and Bryant. He's not used to that. He doesn't like doing it, but he's been forced to do it because of the injury to Joe Mazzulla.
If you're a Mountaineer basketball fan, that really has to make you excited, not only about this year, but about the future. That you've got three freshmen playing on a team that's headed towards the tournament and playing well.
Well, I really think this is Bob Huggins' best coaching job. Doing it without a point guard and without an inside post presence. It looks like they're going to the NCAAs.
Jones feeds Howard. He'll drive in the lane. Stripped away. Ruoff got a hand on it. It stays with the Bulls. 18-17, and has been an entertaining ball game so far. Field goal shooting early on. Inbound play, and there's Jones.
Well, South Florida only averages 60 points a game, and they have 20 in the first 11 minutes. So Bob Huggins can't be happy with their defensive effort right now. He's going to continue to switch and match defenses to try to cool off South Florida.
Bryant. Limau is on him. Ruoff creates, but there's no finish. It's kicked away by Ebanks. Sometimes you can over-penetrate and get the ball a little too deep.
Yeah, it looked like Ruoff made a nice play there, but as you said, he got the ball in the lane. It doesn't look like he's looking for a shot. It looks like he's lost a little confidence coming off the Cincinnati game where Raheem Butler was 7-for-26 and just couldn't knock anything down.
Yeah, he was 2-of-11 from beyond the arc in that ball game. Jones starts his drive, kicks it back out to Howard.
West Virginia in their 1-3-1 zone defense, looking to trap soft on the wings.
Jones fires up a wild three. Butler with the rebound. And Deshaun Butler with the left hand. That ball's tipped, and it heads South Florida's way. Today's Big East game is being produced and distributed by ESPN Regional Television. Rich Waltz, along with former Providence coach Tim Welsh, here in the Sun Dome in Tampa, where Stan Heath is trying to build a program. He told us that this is not the style of play that he is planning for this program, but because of injuries, he can't afford to play as up-tempo as he would like, as he did when he was at Arkansas and went to the tournament his last 2 years there.
Well, again, I've been so impressed with South Florida's ability just to stay in games by guarding and defending. They rebound the ball well. They just struggle to score.
Limau looks at the shot clock. Got to get it up. And he's fouled out high. Bob Huggins screaming right now on the bench. Butler picking up a foul. A frustrating day so far for West Virginia in the Sun Dome in Tampa.
Poor record.
And that effort right now has the Bulls on top by three. Remember, they beat Marquette on this floor when Marquette was number 8 in the country. Jones off a screen. And he'll start his drive. Kick to Howard for a three. Here comes West Virginia. Ebanks back up top. Bryant, freshman, seeing a lot of time. Kevin Jones has a couple of buckets. Butler, quick trigger, bang.
That's what Bob Huggins likes to see. Good patience, good ball movement, good spacing. They reverse the ball twice. They have a lot of cutters cutting down the middle of the floor and popping back off screens there. Butler squared himself up nice for the nice jumper from the wing.
Butler had 27 the first time these two teams played, and those his first three. That's a walk. Espinoza shuffled his feet.
Well, Espinoza's posted up too far outside the lane. They shouldn't give him the ball there. They got to keep running things through Jones and Howard, and those other, the bigs can kind of play off that. Rivas, Gilchrist, Espinoza, they'll play off the guards. I mean, they can't try to force things down low.
The Mountaineers will finish at home with DePaul and Louisville before headed to New York. Butler shy on the three. And everybody is headed to New York this year. Jones out ahead. Missed the layup. There was plenty of contact, but I think Jones initiated it. Butler went for the dunk. Gilchrist made sure there would be no flush.
Nice take here by Butler. He forced the jumper on the last possession. Good take there off the bounce, off the miss by Jones on the other end.
Butler got bailed out. If you saw that replay, the ball had slipped out of his hand before the foul. But nonetheless, he gets to the line, averaging over 20 points a game in Big East conference play, which is fourth best.
He's just had an outstanding season. A guy that stepped up his game from his freshman year, now a junior, a go-to guy, has the highest point total in the Big East in a single game this year against Villanova.
So Bob Huggins in West Virginia back on top, 22-20. And as we've seen, South Florida kind of a grinded out half court team. Jones, Gilchrist. Howard comes to rescue the ball. Shot clock down to five. Howard, a crossover, forced the jumper. They ran lots of clock, did not get a good shot. Bryant on Limau, who blocks the shot, but got plenty of Bryant in the process.
Well, West Virginia has stepped up their defensive intensity in the last 6 minutes of the game. On the last TV timeout, I'm sure Bob Huggins was in their face about getting up on the ball and giving better help and rotating better, not allowing easy penetration in the lane. And you see USF's offense has now suddenly stalled.
How do you get the emotions in check for your team if you're Bob Huggins, especially after Thursday night?
Well, it's a difficult situation because now, you know, at the end, I always felt the end of February heading into March, it's a difficult time for your basketball team, especially if you've had a good solid year. You start thinking about the Big East tournament. You start thinking about if you're going to be in the NCAA tournament. But, you know, the veteran coach that Bob Huggins is, he's been to so many tournaments over the years, whether it be Cincinnati or West Virginia. He understands how to get his team motivated and tell them every game counts the same. And this is a league game, no matter where it is or what record South Florida has.
Gabby Bilardo has checked in. That's him with the ball right now. He does not play a lot, but with the loss of Verdejo, he's out with a foot injury. Bilardo is forced into action here. Rivas made some space, but missed the shot. And Jones swipes the ball from Ebanks, feeds Gilchrist for the layup. I think if there's any question as to whether that man is simply a scorer, he's answered it here in the first 15 minutes.
Well, when he came out of high school, I saw him a lot in high school, and obviously as a freshman, he was just a pure scorer, but he's completely worked on all facets of his game where he's a ball handler, he's a defender, and there you see him, you know, putting his nose into the play and creating another opportunity for South Florida.
John Flowers in for West Virginia. Ruoff feeds the post, it's Ebanks. And Howard tried to sneak around and swipe the ball. He gets called for the foul.
Well, here you see it. You know, West Virginia outlets the ball, and then Ebanks tries to put it on the floor, and Jones deftly steps in. Bob Huggins wanted a foul, but Gilchrist with the good finish.
Now, Stan Heath said earlier this year that after a great freshman year that Dominique Jones had, he did not start this year well. And he said he sat Jones down and talked about coming back as a sophomore, and remember how hard you had to work as a freshman to get what you got. You still have to work even harder now. And Jones realized that and suddenly kicked it into gear.
Well, sometimes the bright lights of the hype of a great freshman year can get to young players' heads, but that's why they're lucky to have Stan Heath to keep him in check, and he certainly turned it around.
Great backdoor cut, probably a foul. I think South Florida got a break.
Certainly Bob Huggins wanted a foul there.
Yeah, they get the ball down a point. Howard penetrates. Williams sends it in.
Williams! South Florida doing a nice job of spreading it out against the 1-3-1 zone of West Virginia, getting the ball into the gaps, finding that backside forward open on the reversal.
A little 2-3 zone look. Ruoff can smell a zone, although he has not shot the ball well here in this one, nor did he on Thursday against Cincinnati.
Look for Butler to flash into the middle of the zone to try to beat it from the paint.
Flowers, 15-footer. Williams the rebound. And the University of South Florida with the ball and a one-point lead, approaching 3 minutes left, first half. Bilardo, baseline drive, he's in trouble. Finds Williams. Butler the rebound.
Tough there, tough move by Williams there. I think he was a little out of position to take that shot in the middle of the lane.
One thing West Virginia has not been able to do is speed this game up. That one's loose. Ebanks got it back. Flowers. Jones. powered the rebound.
Well, South Florida will struggle to score, but they continually switch defenses. They're contesting shots. They're doing a nice job on their blockouts on the interior, limiting West Virginia to one opportunity.
Jones misses the three. And West Virginia has the ball. 1 point game. Mountaineers trying to get to 9-7. Add to that tournament resume, improve the RPI, a shove from behind by Aris Williams. Free throws for West Virginia when we get back. West Virginia on the road, University of South Florida. Not very kind host right now, playing hard and up by a point.
Feet wet at this level as a young player. They need a point guard to play more consistently. They need another guard scorer. But you know, having said all that, they play tough. They play strong. They're hanging in most games. Tonight, I like their game plan. They're switching defenses. They're very patient on offense. And so far, they're hanging in this basketball game with good toughness.
And they've had two injuries, two season-ending injuries to guys that would be starting. Mike Mercer, the transfer from Georgia, who tore an ACL. Mola Balaji Ajayi out with a knee injury. He was a big, a 6'9 senior. So you take those two guys out, and you take Verdejo out. Williams missed the shot. Ebanks over the top to get the rebound.
Well, injuries are a key part of any season. You look at Dominique Jones out now for the year at Marquette. They've lost two in a row now. Look at Blake Griffin down at Oklahoma. They lost two in a row when he went out of the lineup. So when you lose a key major player, it's very, very difficult to recover.
Especially when you're rebuilding a program and you're just looking for a foothold in a conference like the Big East. Straight on Ebanks. Missed the jumper. Bryant runs down the rebound. And a second chance here for West Virginia. Mountaineers shooting 39% so far. Approaching the final minute, first half, Ruoff, clean look at a three. Well, that's got to feel good for that kid.
He does. You know, he's gotten the half without scoring. He's got to just get his feet set like that and just square up and shoot it. Looks like he was aiming the ball earlier. That was a good look for Ruoff.
West Virginia, a four-point lead. Backdoor cut, Williams a dunk, and he's fouled. Boy, Bob Huggins nearly jumped right out of his blue sport coat.
West Virginia foul number 5, Kevin Jones. That's his first team's fifth. Basket by Williams is good.
Well, good inside-out attack by West Virginia here. Being probing the zone, getting the ball in the middle floor, extra pass, short baseline, then looking at Ruoff on the wing for a wide-open look. And then here, Bob Huggins was very upset that they're outside pressuring the big guy, Williams. There's no need to overplay him on the perimeter. He's only a catch-and-shoot dunker, and that's what they gave him.
He's not screaming at the officials right now. He's screaming at his defense. And what was a four-point lead now melts down to just a one-point lead.
Well, nice job again by South Florida. I mean, West Virginia made a scheme mistake there by overplaying the big guy in the perimeter, but South Florida identified it, and they had good spacing, and Howard made the nice look inside to Williams.
Jones, Bryant, Butler. You can see he just wants to get going. A lot of contact, no whistle. And a tip follow. Good hustle by Kevin Jones. 6 points off the bench for Jones.
Well, Jones and Ebanks continue to be good forwards off the bench for West Virginia. Ebanks as a starter. Jones coming in as two freshmen that are long and really give them second shot opportunities.
So we're closing in on halftime. And coming up at the half, Big East Championship memories. We'll take a look back at some of the greatest moments in Big East Championship history. How many teams will the Big East have in the dance? We'll do a little bracketology dancing and first half highlights and stats. And what has been an interesting first half here, and you've got West Virginia, a team with an RPI of 20, seemingly headed towards the tournament. Bob Huggins and his team had an agonizing final minute against Cincinnati on Thursday night. And they come in here against a South Florida team that is just 3-12 and has lost 5 in a row in the Big East. But the Bulls are not playing like that.
Well, they don't ever play where they just don't show up. And that's the thing. They don't have a lot of offensive skill. Today, they're taking what West Virginia's giving them. West Virginia has shown them some 1-3-1 zone. They're taking away Jones, but Howard's done a nice job. Williams has done a nice job. They're throwing it inside to Gilchrist to shrink the defense. If Jones can get going, South Florida could pull something special today.
Looks like the Bulls are going to play for the last shot here in the first half. Jones waits for a screen, gets it. Step back, little crossover. Howard in the corner. Got to get the shot up. Rivas in low, got it up, but it's short. And the first half is over. The Bulls had the lead much of the first half. West Virginia with a push at the end to get a three-point lead here in Tampa, in the Sun Dome, in the Big East. West Virginia 30, the University of South Florida 27. Halftime is coming up.